Hey guys, welcome back to Streaming Nerds, and I'm back with another video tutorial. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can factory reset your Android box. And by factory resetting the Android box, it will clean and remove whatever you have downloaded or installed on the box. And that's why it is called the factory reset, because it resets everything on the device to the time when you received the box from the factory. And the reasons behind factory resetting your device, well, there are many, but one of the prominent ones that I can think of right now is that when your device is slow and you can feel it, that device is not performing up to the mark. At that time, if you factory reset your device, that will definitely help. And the other reason that I can think of that is when something is not working on the device properly, you call up the seller or the company that you bought your Android box from, the first thing that they tell you is to factory reset. So factory resetting is a good option if something is not working or your device has become laggy or slow. So factory resetting is a good option in these scenarios. So I'm going to show you how you can factory reset your device by going into the recovery menu. So here is how you can do that. So as you can see right now, my Android box is connected to my monitor and it's running. But to factory reset it, you would need to turn it off. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it off. So as you can see, my Android box has been turned off. I press the on off button on my Android box and it's off. And now what you need to do is you need to press the recovery button. And then while you keep the recovery button pressed, start your device. And then it will go into the recovery menu. And I'm going to show you what a recovery button looks like. And for that, I will need to remove the cables on my Android box. So let me show it to you. I have removed the power source and the HDMI, and let me show it to you. And as you can see, that is the restore button, guys. It looks like a hole, but that's how it is. And on my box, it is next to the USB port, but on your device, it can be, you know, to the back side or to the other side as well. So just check it out on your box where the restore button is. So as you can see, my restore button is right here. And we need to press it with a pin, or we can use a pen. I will use a pen for resetting the device and going into the recovery menu. So now let me go back and attach the cables again to this Android box. So I'm gonna use my pen here, as you can see, and I'm gonna insert it into the restore button here. So I have inserted it into the restore button and I have pressed it. And it looks like something has pressed inside it. So keep it like that, keep it pressed, and then go ahead with my left hand. I'm gonna press the start button on my Android box. So it has turned blue, as you can see, from red. And I'm still holding the restore button. I'm not letting it go. So after around 5 to 8 seconds, you can leave the pen and you can let go the restore button. So now I'm gonna leave my pen to the side, and now it should automatically go into the recovery menu. So let's wait a little while till it goes into the recovery menu. And now, as you can see, the recovery menu has appeared on the screen. And I'm gonna take my camera closer to the screen so that you can see the recovery menu. So that is the recovery menu, guys. And as you can see, the first option is reboot system now. And then there is apply update from EXT. Then there's apply update from cache and apply update from ADB. But in here, the first thing that you need to do is you need to go on to wipe cache partition. And you can see this option is right here. I have selected it with my normal remote. So the first thing that you need to do in order to factory reset your device will be to wipe cache partition. So that option is right here. I'm gonna press OK on my remote. At the bottom, it's saying wiping cache, and then it says cache wipe complete. So the cache wipe is complete, and now it has taken us back to the main recovery menu, which it always does after completing an operation, after completing a procedure. So the next thing that you need to do is you need to go on to wipe data factory reset. You can see that the option is right here, wipe data factory reset. I have selected it
and I'm gonna press OK on my remote. After pressing OK, it gives me a few options saying no, 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 and then there is one option saying yes, and that's what you need to select and press OK. And once you press OK, it will factory reset your device. It will clear out everything, remove all the garbage, all that is loading up your device. It will remove everything out and it will become as clean as you receive the box. And after it factory resets your device, it will go back to the main recovery menu. So it will again come to this menu, which is this one. And in here, you will go on to the first option, which is reboot system now. And then you click OK on your remote and it will just go ahead and reboot your device. So that is how you can factory reset your device, guys. You just need to follow this video and the instructions that I have provided in this video, and you will be able to factory reset your device. So that's it for this video, guys. And this video is very important and very useful. So make sure that you share this with your friends so that they can also take the benefit from this video. And I'll be back with more awesome videos. So stay tuned to my channel, and I love you all. Bye-bye.